Hello humans, Blaziken Boy TV here, and today we are back in Pokemon Sword and Shield, and we're going to be doing another Wi-Fi battle. So it's been a while since we've done one of these. So my last one, which was my first one, was against MrEpicWafflez, and this time we're going against, you guessed it, we're going against MrEpicWafflez again. So yeah, we're doing a single battle, and 1-6 Pokemon. So yeah, I'll show you guys our teams. He has Blastoise, Dragonite, Clefable, Boltund, Gorgeist, and the best Pokemon of all time, Blaziken. I'm glad he decided to go with the best Pokemon. And my team is Gigalith, Drifblim, Arcanine, Togekiss, Aegislash, and Among Us. So yeah, that's why his name is Imposter, and then also Togekiss is a crewmate. So I say we just start off. Wait, I accidentally clicked something. There we go. We'll start off with Imposter, then we'll go into Drifblim just in case he decides to like use Whirlwind or Roar or Dragon Tail or something. We tried to record this a few seconds ago, but that didn't work out. That battle didn't really work out. So yeah, like that battle, we kind of messed up in that battle. So let me try. There we go. That'll be a much better camera angle. I am using a microphone. You can see in the reflection. I don't know if it's a very good microphone or anything, but yeah. Starting off with his Clefable, all right. There is one imposter among us. That's a reference to Among Us, by the way. A game that was popular for a little while, but it's dying now. So we'll start off with Spore. Probably gonna swap into something. We're not doing Dynamax, by the way. Alright, he's going for Stealth Rocks. That might hurt. But luckily I don't have like a Charizard or anything. That'll hurt Togekiss a lot. Alright, so now I am going to I'll set up the sun in case he wants to, like hurt me. Like if he wants to swap in and use an attack and hurt the imposter, then we can use the synthesis to heal him. And I'm assuming he's going to swap out now, maybe. So I'm gonna try and predict it and use Spore. Yes! Let's go! That's what I wanted. He's swapping into the best Pokemon ever. He probably did not predict that I'm going to predict his move. Yeah. I love using Imposter. It's awesome. I love being Imposter in Among Us, and I love using Imposter. So, I will go for Spore in case he tries to withdraw again, which he probably will. No, he's not, so I'm not going to get it right. Speed boost is annoying, though, that's for sure. Don't wake up. Good. He might wake up next turn. I hope not. I hope that he stays awake. He's honestly probably just going to stay like this. He's probably going to stay in with his Blaziken, so I don't want to risk Imposter because Imposter is really good. So what I'll do, I'm going to I would swap into Gigalith, but he is also a fighting type. Blaziken is also a fighting type. I don't know what could take down a Blaziken. I'll go with Arcanine, because a fire type move will not hurt Arcanine. Okay. Yes! I predicted it. Good, 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 good. That's great. Alright, so Extreme Speed will go first. He is very, very, very fast. The speed boost. However, that won't matter because we have Extreme Speed. Oh, that did not do as much as I would like it to. That is the end of my Arcanine, sadly. So now I'm going to swap into something a little bit better. If the Stealth Rocks weren't up, I would swap into Gigalith, then go immediately into Drifblim, because then he would use a fighting type move, but it wouldn't affect Drifblim. But the Stealth Rocks are up, so I really can't afford to be playing around like that. Okay, so now, this will be risky. It'll be very risky, in fact. I will swap into Drifblim. And I'm going to try and use my strategy with Drifblim. I don't know if I used it in the last video, but I might have. That does quite a lot, and I don't like that. I don't like how the Stealth Rocks did that much. But, you know, like, half my team is flying or weak to rock. I have Arcanine, who's weak to rock. Drifblim and Togekiss are weak to rock. Yeah, half my team's weak to rock. So, Stealth Rocks is really, like, my biggest threat. He's going for U-turn, which does almost nothing. But that is good, because we have a free turn to just set up, essentially. Sending out Snowbolt the Bulldog. I like that name, Snowbolt. I hope all he has is like Zap Cannon or Thunder or something, which is like a move with bad accuracy. Because, yeah. Because if he has Thunder, please don't hit, please. Yes! Let's go! Drifblim is a beast! Alright, now minimize again. Then we'll just use Hypnosis after this. It might be pushing it. Because if we get extremely unlucky, which we could. Nah, I'm not gonna risk it. I don't wanna risk it. So we're going to use Baton Pass. Please don't hit. Good. I'm glad I didn't risk it, because it might have hit next turn if I had gone for Hypnosis there. But Hypnosis might have missed, and then it might have hit next turn. Now, who do I want to go into? I'm thinking I may want to go into Ultra Slash, maybe? I don't know. That does kind of scare me, because he does have that Blaziken. Alright, I'm gonna have to go into Aegislash. All Alright, so I'll go for Shadow Claw. I hope nothing will hit Aegislash. The Minimize is carrying over. Good, we're still avoiding everything. And now we should be able to kill the Bullfun. No, it'll be a two-hit KO. While we can't really do anything with, while the Bolton can't really do anything, I think I might set up. I'm gonna try and set up with just one sword stance. It might be risking it. I'm not gonna risk it anymore. Just go straight for the Shadow Claw. This will kill Snowbolt. I know that. He's probably kind of frustrated because of the Minimize. And we're getting a crit. It would have been nice to have that last turn. But, you know, it's always nice to get a crit. Even though I didn't really need it. Yoshi! I love that name. I just realized that's a great name for a Dragonite. I feel like he has a move with perfect accuracy on his Dragonite. I don't know why. I don't know if Dragonite can even learn that. Okay, Dragonite. Shadow Claw? I hope we can kill it with Shadow Claw. Because that is pretty scary. It'll be a 3-hit KO, maybe 4-hit, I don't know. No, 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 no! Survive, survive! He died, no! That's terrible. I can't send you out. I can send you out. I guess I can send you out. I think he's going to swap out. I'll be honest. Normally, with crewmate, I would... By the way, this is another reference. I thought it would be funny to make a reference to Among Us by having imposter and crewmate. Normally, I would just go for Dazzling Gleam, alright? But this time, I'm going to try and predict that he is going to be swapping. No, he's not going to swap. I should have gone for that. The red card. It's fine. The red card is going to swap out. Yes! That's what I was hoping for it to swap out to. Will the Thunder Wave fail? Yeah, it's gonna fail. I forgot that it was asleep. But anyways, what we'll do, we are now going to do Air Slash. And hopefully we'll get the flinch. I think we're faster than it. Yes, we are. Either don't wake up or get a flinch. Good, it's not gonna wake up. We should be able to kill it, hopefully, if we're lucky. No, the Leftovers is going to be very tanky and very annoying.
Leftovers are sort of annoying to have on tanky Pokemon.
Sorry, I had to adjust the camera there. Because I'm recording with my phone. Alright, so... Air Slash again. Sorry about that. Technical difficulties there. All those technical difficulties. Alright, Luma woke up, and this might be the end. I think it will be. Yes, it's definitely going to be. Now... I don't know what I want to swap into now. I feel like it's not safe to have Imposter out. I don't know, it just doesn't seem very safe. Because, I mean, he could easily swap into Dragonite or Blaziken, two major threats. Blaziken is what I'm worried about. I mean, I've used Blaziken so many times in the past. I know how strong it is. And I know that it can be threatening a lot. I'll just go for Rock Slide. I'm sure either Rock Slide or Heavy Slam will hit it, but I'm locked in Choice Band, so. Oh, you got a crit. Alright, goodbye Luma, and he's gonna send out the Blaziken now. I have a feeling he'll send out Blaziken. But I have a strategy. I do have a strategy. Okay, he's going to be sending out the Gourgeist. So, let's see. I might send out Imposter. I don't know. I think I'm going to stay in with Gigalith for now. I'll try and go with Rock Slide. That could be annoying, be burn. Rock Slide's not going to do a lot since it's a grass type. That did more than I thought it would. I will say that. Does he have... Wait, two Pokemon have leftovers? Huh, I thought that it wouldn't let you do that. I'm not sure. For some reason, I was thinking the battles wouldn't let you have two Pokemon with the same item. But apparently they do. Rock Slide again. Ooh, that'll hurt. That'll probably kill. Yeah, it killed. There was no way we were surviving that. It was a grass type move, super effective, and we had the burn. This will be pretty threatening. I hope he doesn't have a ghost type move. We're down to two guys. Yes, we have two guys left. I'm going to send out Drifblim. And Drifblim is going to use the same minimize strategy. I hope we're faster than it, and I hope that he will miss the first turn. Please miss? Yeah. Wait, no. I was about to be like, yes, because I thought that he had missed. But we'll get another minimize, and hopefully that Phantom Force will not hit. No! That's pretty bad. It's kind of odd because Phantom Force is the name of a Pokemon move and a Pokemon TCG set. We'll have to risk it with Imposter. I feel like Imposter can hold his own pretty well. Can grass types even get hit by Spore? I don't know. Let's see. Oh, by the way, guys, grass types apparently cannot get hit by Spore. I just did that in case you guys forgot. So, yeah. We do a synthesis. 2 minutes left. It's really annoying how the battles will end immediately after 20 minutes. The footage has been going on for about 20 minutes. It'll probably be hard to upload this. Normally longer footage is hard to upload. It'll be faster than me, I believe, so I'm going, it'll use Phantom Force, and now I can heal. That was what I was planning. Alright, so we'll have to make this fast. Solar Beam. I gotta go for it. I haven't used Solar Beam at all yet. I've mostly been stalling. And Solar Beam, I can really only use it once. And it's going to waste my one time because I have the red herb. But it's going to dodge it because it's, because it's still doing the Phantom Force. So, I can really only use it once if I don't want it to take 2 turns. And honestly, in competitive Pokemon, you can't really afford to lose a turn to charge up. So I'm just going to have to stall. And I'll lose the battle by default. Because I have 2 Pokemon and he has 1. Or do I have 1 or 2? I think I have 1, maybe. And it is over, unfortunately. Wait a minute. We still have 60 seconds. I think I'm stalling pretty good with just an Amoongus. It'll probably go with Phantom Forces again. I'm unfortunately going to lose because of the stalling. I wish that it didn't do that where it immediately ends after 20 minutes because sometimes battles take longer than 20 minutes. A lot of times in the competitive competitive games, sometimes it'll take 25 to 30 minutes. But yeah, anyways, thanks for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe. Make sure to also go subscribe to Mr. Epic Waffles. And he's the 2 times winner because he also won last time. It was pretty close both times. But yeah, he won this time and last time. I will have his link down in the description down below in case you want to go check him out. Make sure to go subscribe to him. And yeah, we'll probably do many more awesome collabs. So thanks for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.